The history of rock and roll continues with a chart sweep of the hits of 1958.
They're really rocking in Boston and Pittsburgh, PA. Deep in the heart of Texas and round the Frisco Bay. All over St. Louis and down in New Orleans. All the cats gonna dance with Sweet Little 16. Sweet Little 16. She just got to have about a half a million. Famed autograph, her wallet filled with pictures. She gets them one by one, becomes so excited. Watch her look at her run, boy. Oh, mommy, mommy, please may I go? It's such a sight to see somebody steal the show. They'll be rocking on bandstand in Philadelphia, PA. Deep in the heart of Texas, around the Frisco Bay. All over St. Louis, way down in New Orleans. All the cats gonna dance with Sweet Little 16. Be rocking on bandstand, Philadelphia, PA. Deep in the heart of Texas, and around the Frisco Bay. All over St. Louis, way down in New Orleans. All the cats gonna dance with oh, Sweet Little 16. Sweet Little 16. She's got the grown-up blues, tight dresses and lipstick. Sporting high heel shoes. Oh, but tomorrow morning she'll have to change her train and be Sweet 16 and back in class again. But they'll be rocking in Boston, Pittsburgh, PA, deep in the heart of Texas, and on the Frisco Bay.
Chuck Berry and Sweet Little 16, the first and biggest of his eight hits from 1958. The tune was inspired by a breathless 11-year-old autograph hound whom Chuck had met backstage at a concert in Denver. The history of rock and roll sweeps on through a collage of number one records from 1958, starting with one released in 1957, but it became number one in 1958.
Don't feel that way. Heavenly shades of night are falling. It's twilight time.
I told the witch doctor I was in love with you.
Dream, 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 dream.
It was a one-eyed, one-horned, flying purple people eater.
You ain't gonna rock and roll no more.
Don't tell that.
I was a fool.
Volare. Oh, where are you, little star?
Where are you?
Many a tear has to fall, but it's all in the game.
My one and only prayer is that someday you'll care.
Hang down your head, Tom Dooley. Hang down your head and cry.
No, no, no him is to love, love, love him.
Very Very good, boys.
Let's sing it again. Yeah, let's sing
no,
it again.
That's enough. Let's not overdo it.
What do you mean overdo it? We want to sing
now,
it
wait
again.
A minute, boys.
New faces on the pop scene from 1958 included the Chipmunks, Neil Sedaka, the Shirelles, Brooke Benton, the Kingston Trio, Bobby Darin, and Dion. 1958 was also the year that a Texas group captured a Grammy Award for Best Rhythm and Blues Recording. Leader Dave Burgess recalled how the Champs got lucky.
Tequila was an afterthought. Tequila was strictly a B-side that we made up the song as we went along on the in a rehearsal room at the last minute. We did one take. It took us about 4 minutes. And it turned out to be, of course, the A-side all the way and launched a whole career for the group.
The Champs, featuring on lead guitar, Glenn Campbell. Later, the Champs personnel would change to include Jimmy Seals and Dash Crofts on such hits as Too Much Tequila and Limbo Rock. Next, a group from Staten Island that took their name from a whiskey bottle. Their first and only hit is coming up on the history of rock and roll. The history of rock and roll continues with the hits of 1958.
Where are you, little star?
Where are you?
Oh, 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 ra-da-da-da-da-doo. Oh, 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 ra-da-da-da-da-doo.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I wonder where you are. Make this wish come true tonight. Search for
The Elegance and Little Star, a nursery rhyme rewritten into one of the biggest hits of 1958. 1 month after Little Star, an East Texas disc jockey made his mark on the history of rock and roll. Producer Bill Hall remembered how J.P. Richardson's biggest hit came about.
We were going to the studio to do another song, which was Purple People Eater Meets the Witch Doctor. And the gentleman in Houston that owned the recording studio and the label, and he said, what do you have for the other side? And I said, we'll have something. Well, the big bopper, who was J.P. Richardson, wrote Chantilly Lace on the way to the studio.
Hello, baby. Yeah, this is the big bopper speaking. Oh, you sweet thing. Do I what? Will I what? Oh, baby, you know what I like. Chantilly lace and a pretty face and a ponytail hanging down, wiggling a walk and a giggling a talk. Make the world go round. Ain't nothing in the world like a big-eyed girl to make me act so funny, make me spend my money, make me feel real loose like a long-necked goose, like a girl.
Oh, baby, that's what I like.
What's that, baby? But, oh, honey. But, oh, baby, you know what I like. Chantilly lace had a pretty face, had a ponytail hanging down, a wiggle in the walk and a giggle in the talk. Lord, make the world go round, round, round. Ain't nothing in the world like a big-eyed girl to make me act so funny, make me spend my money, make me feel real loose like a long-necked goose or like a girl.
Oh, baby, that's the one I like.
What's that, honey? Pick you up at 8 and don't be late. But, baby, I ain't got no money, honey. Oh, all right, honey, you know what I like. Chantilly lace and a pretty face, ponytail hanging down, a wiggle in a walk and a giggle in a talk. Low, make the world go round. Ain't nothing in the world like a big-eyed girl to make me act so funny, make me spend my money, make me feel real loose like a long-necked goose or like a girl.
Oh, baby, that's what I like.
Chantilly Lace from J.P. Richardson, better known as the Big Bopper.
Originally, you know, he didn't do it as the Big Bopper, you know, where he says, hello, this is the Big Bopper. When the record was being recorded, he was doing commercials for a lawnmower, Big Yazoo. And he started off as the Big Yazoo, and we says, no, you can't do that because it's a commercial item. So he went back to the Big Bopper.
The Big Bopper went on to tour America and was set to receive a gold record for Chantilly Lace in the spring of 1959. Before he could, though, he was killed in a plane crash, along with Buddy Holly and Ritchie Valens. Next, a group that developed their sound by singing in the echo of a New York train station. Little Anthony of the Imperials talked about his singing style.
I was 16, and my voice had developed into a deeper tone, but I would always talk like I'm talking now. And George Goldner, the owner of the record company, told me, he says, why don't you sing like you talk? And I couldn't figure out what he meant. So I would go home day in and day out and try different ways to sing like he said, and it wouldn't come out. To one day I caught a cold, very bad head cold, and it forced me to use my wind a different way, which came out with a tone. That is what Little Anthony's known of, as simple as that.
Little Anthony remembered the Imperials' biggest record.
George Goldner told us at the recording session that he wanted us to sing this song, and we thought it was awfully dumb. Didn't want to sing it, but he insisted, and he was the man, so we sang it. And we rehearsed it in about an hour. And if anybody remembers that record in the background, they'll hear a sound that is ooh, ooh, ooh. Well, we didn't create that sound. That sound came from another song. It was done by another group. We had to think of something real quick, and we couldn't think of anything, and we had to think of whatever it was. It had to be a simple tonation. And that came from Earth Angel. Same background. If you listen to it, the Penguins.
You don't remember me.
but I remember you. 'Twas not so long ago you broke my heart in two. Tears on my pillow, pain in my heart caused by in my heart for
Imperials and Tears on My Pillow from the summer of 1958. The Imperials' style was called doo-wop, a fast-fading form of music that dominated much of 50s rhythm and blues. Another group on the doo-wop bandwagon was the Moonglows, who had their biggest record just 1 month later.
Thou shall never love another.
Thou shall never love another.
And stand by me all the while.
And stand by me all the while.
Take happiness with the heartaches.
Take happiness with the heartaches.
And go through life wearing a smile.
And go through life wearing a smile.
Oh, how happy we will be if we the Ten Commandments of love, of love. Thou should always have faith in me.
Thou should always have faith in me.
In everything I say and do.
In everything I say and do.
Love me with all your heart and soul.
Love me with all your heart and soul.
Until our life on earth is through. Oh, how happy we will be if we keep the Ten Commandments of love. Oh, how happy we will be
commandments of love. Oh, how happy we will be if we keep the Ten Commandments of
Moonglows and the Ten Commandments of Love, a song later reworked into a shampoo commercial. The history of rock and roll sweeps on through a collage of landmark hits from 1958.
Oh, man, short shorts.
Take out the papers and the trash.
Stupid Cupid, stop picking on me.
The Elf, Pop the Buzzard, and the Oreo.
We wrote the book of love.
Won't you ever read up around your neck?
Johnny is a joker that's a trying to steal my baby.
He's a bird dog.
Mm-hmm. My baby loved the wet darn blue.
It's far too late for you to notice.
Come, let's stroll.
Know there was a party going on. There was a suspicion and a smash.
Maybe someday your name will be in lights saying, Johnny, be good tonight.
Good golly, Miss Molly, sure like the bomb.
You leave me.
Breathless. 1958 was also the year that early American folk music was reborn, as Bob Shane of the Kingston Trio recalled.
Before the Kingston Trio, there was no means of the folk world expressing itself on records. Top 40 lists meant you played top 40 rock songs, and to break through that was darn near impossible. When it did break through, that opened the door for just myriads of folk singers to come through and express themselves.
Throughout history, there have been many songs written about the Eternal Triangle. This next one tells the story of a Mr. Grayson, a beautiful woman, and a condemned man named Tom Dooley. When the sun rises tomorrow, Tom Dooley must hang.
Hang down your head, Tom Dooley. Hang down your head and cry. Hang down your head, Tom Dooley. Poor boy, you're bound to die.
I met her on the mountain. There I took her life. Met her on the mountain. Stabbed her with my knife.
Hang down your head, Tom Dooley. Hang down your head and cry. Hang down your head, Tom Dooley. Poor boy, you're bound to die.
This time tomorrow, reckon where I'll be. Hadn't have been for Grayson, I'd have been in Tennessee.
Well, now, boy,
hang down your head, hang down your head and cry.
Oh, well,
hang down your head and cry. Oh, boy, you're bound to die.
Well, now, boy,
hang down your head and cry. Hang down your head and cry. Hang down your head and cry. Oh boy, you're bound to die.
This time tomorrow, reckon where I'll be. Down in some lonesome valley, hanging from a white oak tree.
Hang down your head, Tom Dooley. Hang down your head and cry. Hang down your head. die. Poor boy, you're bound to die. Poor boy, you're bound to die.
Poor boy, you're bound to die.
Dave Guard, leader of the Kingston Trio, recalled how Tom Dooley came about.
Sort of a gray-haired guy with glasses came in, sang some of his favorite songs, among which was Tom Dooley, and we picked up on it immediately, thought it was, but it's a real legend. We visited the places and saw what happened, and it's utterly believable. Tom Dooley was a Civil War veteran, Southern side, came back, I think he killed his girl in 1867, and was, try to make it across the hill to Tennessee by night with his other girlfriend, and it said that he composed the song himself just before he died, in, I guess, 1867, you know, the night before he was about to be hung, really. It's a real thing.
Tom Dooley was just one of many hits for the Kingston Trio, who paved the way for a folk revival in the 60s. Next, the Platters, when the history of rock and roll continues into 1959.